why not get that energy to begin the ball game? And it also, I think, gives you a score. One of the things we've talked about, IUPUI, throughout the years, where's the scoring come from? He's done a remarkable job with this ball club. People have to be impressed with the direction they're headed. They could not be happier with the job that Jason has done.
In this rivalry, Western Illinois has won six consecutive meetings against IUPUI, a departure from the previous years. And we'll talk more about that as the broadcast goes along.
We talked about Elijah Ray. You also see Mason Archie in the lineup. You know, normally Mason comes off the bench. Again, another score. You lose Khufu, you got to find some scoring.
Elijah Ray tries to provide that on the first trip down, and the Jags will get a second look as that ball tips off the hands of Jalen Chapman, a 6'8 junior from the Bronx. He is one of eight new faces on this Leatherneck roster for first-year head coach Billy Wright.
Yeah, and there's a question mark, too, about Aaron Brennan's health. I mean, he's got the ankle situation, too, and it does not start this ball game. But, look, you know what? As balanced and as deep as IUPUI is, doesn't really matter who starts.
Western won the last meeting between these two teams 63-59, so has been the case virtually the entire season. Expect a close matchup. Barksdale gets the bucket.
Good way to start your 100th game. Don't you think? Nice drive to the rim. Nice finish in some traffic.
61st consecutive start for Marcellus. He's the only IUPUI player to start in every game this season. Archie draws a defensive assignment on Covington to get things started. Mohamed Conde, the jump shot does not go. Chapman got the extra possession, but quickly, Josh James there to knock the ball away.
You know, Greg, that was an area the first time these two teams played. Offensive rebounding by Western Illinois was good, and speaking of good, so's Marcellus starting on his 100th game.
We have seen when he's hit his first couple of shots, that has kind of been the green light for him to take off for the rest of the night. Let's see if that continues.
He's effective going to the rim. He really is. When he's able to get inside the lane, he can finish plays.
Not one of the two seniors that will be honored on senior day, but the longest tenured player in the program. This is his fourth year as a part of IUPUI basketball as Western misses yet another shot. Barksdale has played both kind of point guard and small forward roles in his days at IUPUI, so he can kind of plug into a lot of spare pieces for this offensive set for IUPUI. Archie, the turnover, two-on-one opportunity, and a score for Western Illinois' Jabari Sandifer.
Well, Sandifer can really attack the rim. Great in transition. Player of the week, Greg, January the 5th. Very capable offensive player.
The first points come in transition for the Leathernecks. The immediate double. Good recognition by James. Barksdale for three, and could be a big night for Marcellus. He's got all seven IUPUI points.
I think they tell him every game he plays now from here on out is his 100th game. Don't let him actually tally it up. Just tell him this is your 100th game.
We saw him go 4 of 4 from three-point range in a game earlier this season. Not normally a part of his arsenal. Count the basket on the drive for Jalen Chapman.
How about that? That is a big-time move. I mean, Chapman on the great pivot, the quick move, the bump. That's a tough. I mean, that is a very impressive move. Statistically, Jason Gardner's team, Greg, 20.6 fouls, you know, and they give up almost three over, right at three extra field goals a game. It's hard for me as a coach not to say what I want to say. But, you know, I think one thing, too, is that this is an aggressive, Jason has tried to instill this aggressive half-court offense or half-court defense, and they press. They do a lot of things, and sometimes, you know, technique, not what it needs to necessarily be. But I think you can. You want to try to play defense without fouling. I think that's ultimately what everybody tries to do. There's still a work in progress right now on that.
Not sure what the source of the perspiration, condensation, precipitation, whatever it may be.
It's too cold to have any kind of.
Thank you.
It's just too cold.
Kind of the point that I was making. The Indy Fuel played here last night. Just the third time they played here in the month of February as Chapman could not get the free throw to rattle in. He's a 53% shooter. So it was a quick turnaround from last night's hockey game to the basketball floor here at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum. And the Fuel back on the road this weekend. liking the ball movement I'm seeing from IUPUI in the early going.
Well, it's not just the ball movement, Greg. It's the nice, you know, get themselves in positions where they can get back screens, a little on big, big on little, and get some action going to the rim.
And Archie going to be called for taking the extra step, the second IUPUI turnover.
Yeah, frustrating that you get that deep in the possession and you don't get anything out of it, don't get a shot.
You're seeing Western double the post immediately. What does that mean for IUPUI?
You've got to think quickly to get the ball out, rotate, and think opposite. Anytime you get doubled in the post, think opposite. If you can pivot, kick it out, or throw top, and then throw to the opposite wing. But whatever you do, you got to do it quickly.
Fuller's jump shot does not go. Fuller, their second leading scorer, 11 points a game. Elijah Ray quickly moving up the scoring charts for IUPUI. He's got 4.5 a night. That's his first basket.
Well, you like, again, the high-low. They get right into it. No one denies that cut to the elbow. And no one denies, Jabari Sandifer on the drive to the rim.
Sandifer, normally more of a creator. He's a guy that averages 4.5 assists a game, just 7.5 points a game. But he's got 4 of the Leathernecks 6. Play through contact here. Can't play through losing the basketball if you're IUPUI. Their third turnover, Sandifer's wild shot does not go. Now a numbers advantage for IUPUI. Spot up three for Archie. Good weak side rebound by McCall. Misses the putback. Ray in traffic does not go. But he is fouled. That'll lead us to our first.
In some cases, but man, oh man, this isn't the roster he thought he was going to have when things started.
First free throws of this game to be taken by Elijah Ray. The redshirt sophomore from Bowman Academy. He's a 67% free throw shooter.
He's a tough matchup. We've talked about this before, but what are you guarding with a three-man, a wing? You guarding with a guard? You guarding with how do you? Because he can step out, he can score inside. We just need to clean up the free throws a little bit.
Dave Ron Williams, Leo Sfetti checking at the first break for IUPUI with Kufu Naji's absence tonight. There will be a little less play from the bench, and Aaron Brennan's injury a concern as well.
There's no question.
So maybe 10 or only 9 guys will see action for IUPUI this evening.
Absolutely. Fuller on the ball screen just gets past the big guy, Jalen Chapman. Turnover.
Second Western Illinois giveaway. Williams, the second leading scorer for IUPUI and a candidate for the Summit League Sixth Man of the Year. Barksdale trying to make something from nothing that time, and Western now a chance to push the tempo.
Well, they like to push tempo and try to find somebody quickly, as they did with Muhammad Condi. Just miscommunication, Greg, but if you push it up and get some things going offensively, sometimes you'll get an easy one.
First substitution for Western of the game, by the way, Dalen Ankrum wearing number 15 for the Leathernecks. Almost a steal. In fact, it is a steal. Covington off to the races, and Covington misses the layup. Bullet dodged for IUPUI. And McCall at the other end will finish. And Billy Wright will ask for time for Western Illinois. Fifth home win of the season. This is the 12th home game of the campaign for the Jaguars.
Yeah, how crazy is that? Win more on the road than you do at home.
And that has been the case in league play as well. 3 road league wins, just 2 at home, as McCall called for the hand check foul.
Tough matchup. I mean, you're talking about Garret Covington, who's 15 a game, as we mentioned, leads his team in just about everything he does. You give him some space, he can put it on the floor and get to the rim very, very quickly.
Fuller, little nudge to create some space, and it's the basket to go.
He may be their hottest player right now, Greg. In the last 9 ball games, he's averaging 17 a game, and you can see why.
Certainly a candidate for the all-newcomer team in the Summit League, and those awards announced next week before the Summit League tournament. Barksdale scored the first 7 for IUPUI and bumped that tally down to 9 for the first 6 minutes of this game.
Well, it's a kick out on penetration in Western Illinois, a little slow to rotate. Marcellus Barksdale doesn't need much space.
These two teams, though, have like minds. They want to get to the basket early and often.
Yeah, and I think they all feel comfortable, even though this is a Western team that shoots the 3 reasonably well.
On cue, Ankrum rattles that one in.
I'm just saying, they really do, but, especially, with Covington can shoot it, Fuller can shoot it.
It's a team, 34% from three-point range. Western makes 6.5 threes a ball game. And that's going to be a foul against Western Illinois. Williams had established inside position. Just the second whistle against the Leathernecks.
Yeah, Condi trying his best to fight around, and, you know, that's a tough matchup inside. These are two pretty talented kids, quickly going to get him out.
Good news for IUPUI. Brennan enters the game in battling an ankle injury.
One of those game-time decisions, and the decision was positive for Aaron Brennan.
Young man from Garin Catholic High School that spent more time as a starter than a reserve this season. Archie re-enters after a quick break as well.
Game like this, this is an energy game.
And that's going to be an offensive foul on Barksdale.
Well, that's the scouting report, Greg. You know he's going to take it to the rim. If you can step in, you try to draw the foul, and you'll see it right here. Gets a lane. Give Covington credit. Little sales job, but clearly had position.
Importantly for IUPUI, that is their fifth turnover. The game's opening 7 minutes. And Fuller continuing to look to attack.
Yeah,
and
got the extra step.
Struck that pivot foot just a bit.
You know, when you're playing as well as he's played, as we mentioned, the last few ball games, you get confident. You know, you really start to feel good. And they have two real capable scorers, not only in Covington, but obviously in J.C. Fuller. He's put up some nice numbers. You also like the fact that he's pretty solid defensively.
P.J. Boutte into the game for the first time, the junior from Howell High School. His Hornets ranked second in 2A this week. Jamie Battish into the game for Western Illinois, a young man from Australia that is their leading three-point shooter at 43% from three-point range this season. Shot clock at 10. Boutte realizing that Brennan has a mismatch, so immediately tries to get the ball to him. They're going to say travel before contact against Brennan. And that'll lead us to the media timeout. So the turnover problems continue for IUPUI. The Jaguars lead by one.
Looking forward to the whole day.
There's also a basketball legend. In fact, there's two of them in attendance tonight. One of them will be joining us at halftime.
Yeah, we are. We have basketball royalty tonight in the house.
Leathernecks look for their first lead, and they won't get it here.
You know, Covington has an ability to score in difficult situations. Hasn't gotten it going yet. But you can just see that he can get to the rim, get it on the rim quickly, and it, with some authority, even though he's getting bumped.
Barksdale getting a breather here for IUPUI. He's got 9 of their 14. Boutte's shot sent backwards by the efforts of Jabari Sandifer.
I like Sandifer. You'll watch it here. This is great. He's behind, gets it, stays down, doesn't commit the foul right there, too. Coming out of nowhere is Jalen Chapman.
Good news for Western is that Sandifer and Covington are just sophomores. This is a young basketball team, and another steal by Covington. And his shot does not go. Four-car pileup underneath the basket. IUPUI out of there with it.
And Garrett Covington not getting up so quickly.
Hopefully he's all right. It appears to be the case.
No, I think he tried to draw the contact, and he got the contact but did not get a whistle. And you can see here P.J. Boutte, great individual move, Greg. Seriously, the fake, takes it to the rim. You get him in transition. He's fun. Teammates love him. They know that if they're open, they're going to get the ball.
That was not on the shot. That was on the drive, so no free throws for Boutte. Covington checks out for Western. Boutte. Looking at shots, he gets his 2 points that away instead.
Friendly rim here at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum for P.J. Boutte.
Of course, his big moment this year was the game winner in overtime against Ball State back in November for this team's first win in this building. And Dalen Ankrum is lacking the facilities here. That's his second three off the bench.
How about Ankrum? Same spot for two. Ball rotation. You mentioned it. They make six a game.
That young man averages just 3.5 points a game. He's got 6 to lead Western. Chapman playing through the screen, gets whistled for the foul. That is his second.
This is the problem sometimes, Greg, when you have the quote-unquote little on big screen. Little pays
little
the
goes
price.
Down in a heap and draws
little,
the foul.
Little pays the price for it. And I like the reference of playing through contact. Yes. PJ's giving up the body, though, for the team. You know, those little on bigs can create some great opportunities inside.
Condi checks back in. Chapman has a seat with two fouls. Barksdale with 11.
You like it. You know, until that shot, and you had one from three where he shot, it's been off the dribble, going to the rim. This was one bounce jump shot.
By the way, Covington dealing with a bloody nose in the sideline for Western Illinois, so I have to get a little padding, some gauze, and I'll be back out there shortly for Western.
Yeah, we hope he's not gone long.
Ankrum runner, no. Rebound, no. And Condi is fouled, and really for the first time we see Western attack on the glass.
Well, earlier we talked about the fact that the first time they played, Coach Gardner was really disappointed in the board work of his players. And it's this exchange, I think, is symptomatic of that. The last time when they were in Macomb, the Leathernecks beat them on the rim. And that hasn't, as you pointed out, hasn't happened very much in conference play.
Not only is that a strength for IUPUI as Condi gets that to go, it's not exactly a strength for Western Illinois. They have been out-rebounded to the tune of 4.5 boards a game this year.
You would not notice looking at what they've done to this point because they seem to be very active on the glass right now.
Condi hits them both. He is a 55% free throw shooter. And we're tied at 18 and nearly a steal by Sandifer.
Yeah, I like the matchup.
Already three steals for Western Illinois. Two of them belonging to Sandifer. Brennan turns, does not get the roll, and Condi saves the rebound. Good hands by Williams. Good effort by both teams.
It is. We talked about it being an energy game. You need to bring energy.
Fuller, no. Who touched it last? Out of bounds to Western Illinois.
You know, when these types of games, Greg, you talk about those 50-50 plays, those energy-type plays, and you'll see it right here. Both teams really going after it. P.J. Boutte not able to corral it. But these are two teams. We saw the graphic at the start of the ball game, all the statistical analysis. They're very, very similar in how they play. And what wins these kinds of games, can you win those 50-50 plays?
Covington back in after getting a little work on the left nostril. Good look by Ankrum. Condi misses the first one, and eventually Boutte will track it down. Western's had some point-blank looks they have missed tonight.
They really have. That may have been the most glaring one. That's a great pass, just a tremendous look.
Boutte turns. I think that was supposed to be an oop.
I think you're 100% right.
He was thinking assist. He'll take the bucket.
Oh.
And IUPUI back in front.
You know, Dave Ron will have something to say to him after the ball game about taking his assist. That is the Garret Covington that we know about.
And that is the first lead for Western Illinois.
Just in rhythm, off the down screen, the catch, the three.
Covington's first basket. Now McCall lets fire. Not normally his game. Williams keeps it alive, but Fuller tracks it down. Covington, not that time. One of the few bad shots we've seen taken so far in tonight's game.
Yeah, absolutely.
But then again, he's your best player.
You're going to allow that.
And Barksdale.
Speaking of.
14 for Barksdale. I think that qualifies as heat check category for Marcellus. This Western program, one that really struggled for the better part of about 10, 12 years. Jim Molinari completely turned the fortunes of this Western basketball program. Made back-to-back postseasons in 2012 and 2013. Ankrum, not that time. McCall able to snare the rebound. Western team played in the CBI in back-to-back years. Barksdale, no, but Williams is there for the putback.
See, energy play. And another one. Great steal by P.J. Boutte.
Looking
play
for
hard. Greg, play hard.
Barksdale to the bucket. Barksdale scores a bucket. And Marcellus with 16 points. This has been a team that's been all about balance all season long. Not tonight. Marcellus having a pretty good weekend here in the first half.
There's no question. Isn't it amazing what happens when you play hard?
He averages just under 9 points a game. And will pick up the foul here, which might be the only dampener.
11 minutes.
And that's really following up a very good weekend for him. He had 15 at North Dakota State, had 21 in the loss on Saturday. And the runner by Covington does not go.
Well, they've made it difficult for Covington, Greg, to get a good look. If you think about it, they've contested every shot he's taken. They've done a nice job on him. He has not really gotten anything to go, to think, to speak of.
Nice drive and dish by McCall. Boutte can't finish. Good hustle by Ray, but it'll be out of bounds to Western Illinois.
But that's what you have to do, Greg. You throw post, kick out, you penetrate, you skip pass. Good clean look by a good shooter that doesn't go. It doesn't go.
And it's an IUPUI team. The three-point shooting is not going to be their strength, but they have been streaky at times in a good way from three-point range.
Absolutely. And you just feel a certain energy from them tonight. You know, you feel a certain rhythm.
James leaves Ankrum, and Ankrum misses from 19 feet.
Yeah, you're kind of hopeful that you won't leave Ankrum, who's knocked down two threes, and you manage not to suffer for it.
Where does the offense come from with this set when Barksdale's not on the floor?
That's a great question. It has to come from Elijah Ray and Mason Archie. You know, you have James can keep some things going, and you have a capable scorer in P.J. Boutte.
Fuller in the lane, no.
But you keep defending like you're defending. You just grind some out.
Now Archie to the basket, blocked. Fuller got it.
Well, they do, in transition, off turnovers, off rebounds, they can get out, especially if you put the ball in the hands of J.C. Fuller.
This IUPUI lineup all about balance all season long. 9 players average between 4.5 points and 9 points a game. Ray with 5 there. But currently, Barksdale with 16, his teammates with 13.
I like my chances, though. If you got Elijah Ray, can score. Archie can knock down threes, can score off the dribble.
Covington weaves his way through traffic, does not get the basket, but earns 2 free throws.
You like that first step? Man, that's what you call an explosive first step. Now, granted, on the kick out, you don't close it out. You know, your technique needs to be a little bit better. But, boy, he went to the rim in a hurry.
Covington and Sandifer, again, we've lumped them together because they're both sophomores for this team. They're also both in-state kids Western, which has been a bit of an issue over the years, is exactly where's the recruiting base come from to get kids to play in Macomb. Covington is from downstate. He is from Edwardsville, which is, of course, just outside of St. Louis. Sandifer is from Naperville, so he's from the Chicago suburbs.
That bodes well for your recruiting. I mean, if you can get people out of those particular areas, you get in the metropolitan area of Chicago, you're out down around St. Louis in that part of the state. That's important.
And a miss by Covington. Mm. That's rare. An 83% free throw shooter and misses them both.
Yeah, he's not having the efficient offensive night that he's had in quite a few games this year.
Remy Roberts-Burnett into the game. He's on ball defensively against Boutte right now for Western. Ray, a little floater from 14 is good. And Elijah now is 7. He is joining Barksdale for the 1-2 punch tonight for IUPUI.
Again, when you look at, he's capable. We talk about a guy who provides instant offense. He does it, and he does it in a lot of different ways.
Roberts-Burnett, little lefty floater, does not go, and McCall the rebound. Those offensive rebound opportunities becoming fewer and more far in between for Western. Boutte rifles one to James, lost the handle, got it back, lost it again, and finally Western comes out of there with it.
That's a tremendous pass from Boutte. You love how quickly Western Illinois got down and doubled up on the ball.
And that's going to be traveling whistled against Covington.
Mason Archie's a good man. I think if you're comfortable right now with an 8-point lead, the way you're playing, save him and let him play. Now you can let him play 18, 20 minutes in the second half.
Play. Plenty of time in the shot clock here for IUPUI. Again, here's the immediate post-double. Covington got bumped in the nose again. Stand back in there, could not track it down. It'll be out of bounds to Western Illinois. Yeah.
Garrett Covington having a tough night because, you know, Davron Williams on the step through in the double team, elbow catches him right in the nose as he step through. And, boy, he's hoping I can get to the locker room, get out of this half.
Garrett might have prize fighter face at the end of this game.
He really does.
Roberts Burnett stumbled. Boutte with the rebound. He stumbled as well, but found Archie on his way down, but in the three short by Mason. Mason yet to score tonight. He is IUPUI's third leading scorer on the season. And suddenly Western has gone cold from the floor. Another Western player goes down in Conde. Jags have a numbers advantage and a blocking foul whistled against Jamie Battish. As at the other end, Conde and Roberts Burnett collided with each other.
Yeah, they have just been had run into some bad luck, Greg. I mean, banging into one another. You know, your own teammate on that one. And he's hurt. I mean, he's got a little, that was painful.
Again, it is a team in Western that has been without a couple of starters for really conference play for the majority of it. Mike McClusick, a young man from Lake Central High School, has been out since January the 10th with a knee injury. Now, he is in uniform tonight, but we have yet to see him in tonight's game as Davron misses a free throw. The other player in Tate Stensgaard, a 6'8 junior, he did not make the trip. He is out with a wrist injury and has missed the entire month of February.
Yeah, and they, you know, that's a loss. That's a big loss.
And there's a couple of young men from the Indianapolis area that are freshmen that have been redshirting this season primarily due to injury. Jalen Morgan and Kendall Rollins both played for Bill Zick at Pike High School.
Absolutely. Talented kids, very talented kids.
Both those two young men are here, going to spend some time with family these couple days there in Indianapolis before they play in Fort Wayne on Saturday afternoon. Williams hits one of two, and then Fuller simply gives it away right back to IUPUI.
Great defense, though, at the half court.
And the shot clock did not start. That's the reason for the stoppage in play.
You know, the one thing we've seen, Greg, before when IUPUI plays in the Indiana Farmers Coliseum is they will lock in, they'll defend you. They've done a great job defensively tonight. This is how they seem to have played every ball game in this building. That first half, we've talked about how they've played in the first half defensively in terms of defensive average, field goal percentage, defense. It's another one of these nights.
That number has gone up a little bit over the last couple of games, but there was a while where IUPUI was averaging, allowing less than 25 points in the first half of league games. 23 right now. Stand back tips and keeps that one alive.
Nice, smart play.
Justice, the sophomore from West Lafayette, 10th player to see action here in the half. Loves that baseline jumper from right about there.
His mid-range jump shot may be the best on the team. You think about him. Steps out short corner. Great pass by DJ McCall. That's money in the bank.
First double-digit lead for IUPUI. Covington, yes, sir, that's a two.
Comes off the staggered. You know, the catch, the square. Too much space. You're not able to contest it. And he's too good not to make that shot.
Just Covington's second made field goal. He is 2 of 6 from the floor. Williams stripped and taken away by Chapman.
See, and I think Western's too good, Greg, in terms of quick help. You got to catch and go. You can't put it on the floor, I think. You've got to make a quick move to the rim or kick out and try it again.
Western trying to bring this back to maybe about a two-possession game by halftime. That does not help. Slow down, fellas. Hang on, PJ. And Jason Carter has seen enough. 30-second time.
It's going to be a problem.
And not much difference in the shot clock and game clock here. Let's see if IUPUI tries to run this down as best as possible. McCall can't do that because he turns it over off his leg out of bounds.
Mm.
Turnover number 10 by IUPUI.
See, the frustrating thing is you'll get a chance to see it and you're all set. I don't think Western Illinois touched it. I think it was a good call. You know, you call timeout, you set something up.
By the way, Terry Weimer, Lamont Simpson, Darrell Smith, our three-man officiating crew tonight. Covington, step back, tough shot. Neither team really using the shot clock effectively late in this game. Boutte, that's off of his leg out of bounds. And P.J. didn't knock it out of his own hand, but it hit his leg before it caromed out of
bounds.
Well,
trying to push it up as fast as he can. Gets too deep. Maybe a reach from, I think, maybe got caught by Jalen Chapman who knocked it off his leg. But, again, you got to make a decision when you get that deep.
Sandifer, did he get it off in time? It does not matter, as it did not go.
Yeah, I think one of the big keys is if you're IUPUI, you have to continue to defend Garrett Cunningham. He has five at the half, and he's too good a player to be at five. You know he's going to be much more assertive in this half.
Jump shot does not go for Sandifer, but good job by Chapman to get the rebound. Just couldn't get the finish. Another point-blank miss for Western Illinois.
And I mentioned finishing traffic. Finish plays at the rim, which they haven't done to this point.
Barksdale, so much of the offense. He and Ray combined for 23 of the IUPUI 34.
But we talked about earlier, where's the scoring going to come from? Khufu Najee not here.
Khufu out with an ankle injury. Deep three for Ray online, just a little short from some 22 feet or more.
Maybe a step back further than what he needed to be.
Starting five on the floor for Western Illinois. Fuller the miss. One change for IUPUI. Williams gets the start instead of Josh James.
Well, you went energy. You went to your best rebounder.
And that's a blocking foul. And that's, I wouldn't say a break, but that's truly a 50-50 call. Player was moving.
Yeah.
Marcellus kind of used that shoulder. And if it's whistled on Barksdale, that's his third foul.
Can't see it in an angle, but you're right. You know, from our vantage point court side, he may have lowered the shoulder. But, again, you know, you can go through a scouting report and say, hey, Marcellus Barksdale wants to put it on the floor and go to the rim. Yeah, we know that. Try and stop it.
That's a big foul for Western, too, because Chapman now has three. And there's no stopping Marcellus tonight. He's got 18 points.
I'm just, he feels comfortable, you know, gathers himself, you know, is able to decelerate, get the power dribble, go back up to the rim. That's hard to defend, Greg.
And you mentioned this in the, towards the end of the first half. Marcellus played just 11 minutes in the first half because of those two fouls.
Yeah. He's fresh. And the other thing is he only needs maybe a minute, 2 minutes of rest in the second half.
Covington, Archie got a piece, but apparently got some of the arm as well.
He was close. He's right there. Mason Archie, you see it. But, again, you know, Covington is going to get more aggressive and assertive with the ball, and they're going to look for him more. So what they've tried to do to this point is go away from him, have him come off a staggered screen at the top of the key. They've also tried to isolate him, step him off the elbow, and clear a side for him. But you're going to see him try to get much more aggressive going to the rim and getting himself open.
Covington missed two free throws in the first half. That's rare for him. He's got six. Covington really has a chance to be atop a lot of charts when his days at Western Illinois are completed.
Well, think about it. I mean, he's only been there 2 years, and he's already in the top 10 in career three-pointers, top 50 in career points, and this is his sophomore year.
Seven now for Covington. Pulls the Leathernecks back within single digits. Archie just got rid of that ball in time. Nice lead for Williams. Better closeout by Condi. And the scramble for the loose ball sees Chapman come out of there with it.
I tell you what, you got to be tough to score inside, Greg. Both teams are letting them play. Both teams are able to play that way.
Covington the miss and Williams with the pull down. That's now five boards for Dave Ron. And that's Barksdale getting Fuller in the air. And he truly has a scorer's mentality this evening.
He really does.
He'll go to the free throw line for the first two times tonight.
You know, Fuller, you'll see him right here. This shot fake, the step in. Fuller going, what do you want me to do? Well, you got to try to beat him to that spot and maintain your spot. Marcellus Barksdale, we've talked about it, you know, at the half court, on the dribble to the lane, the three-point. How about in transition? Get out. Once that one back, but again, you've got to get to him very quickly. And, Greg, he doesn't need a lot of space to get to the rim.
Barksdale had 22 against Georgia State back over Thanksgiving weekend as he misses both free throws. That is tied for his career high along with a 22.12 rebound effort against Southeast Missouri last year. Covington to Chapman, who misses wildly, and Ray out of there with it.
Throws him off, makes the outlet pass. Great post defense.
And Ray gets it to go.
I'll tell you what, that's a good exchange for Elijah Ray. Gets the big rebound, sprints the floor, scores inside.
That's where last night Ray might have gotten two for boarding with the rebound at the other end, but we play through it tonight, and the Jaguars back in front by double figures. Now Sandifer, that's no good. And off to the races goes IUPUI.
A good decision. You know, Mason Archie may have had the three. Makes a nice pass to DJ McCall. DJ says, I don't have it. It starts to go baseline just as Marcellus Barksdale makes the shallow cut to the corner.
The 11 matches the largest lead of the night for IUPUI, and Barksdale has loved that mid-range game tonight.
Well, you know, it penetrates after the attempted steal, makes you pay. You miss the steal, you don't get it.
Already the third.
Fun day. Takes me back to the days when I used to come watch the Pacers play when I was in high school and college.
And no, the smoke-filled haze will not return to the Coliseum for one day only.
You could just dream.
Some things are better left in the past. Covington traveled.
They just defended him well, Greg. When you think about it, you know, you get the screen, you allow him to get a lane to the rim, but you're there, you close him out, force the walk.
Barksdale. 22 matches his uniform number and his career high.
I don't believe he's going to miss. It's very impressive.
He's had two misses from the floor, two misses from the free throw line. So everything in twos for Barksdale today. Ankrum, not that time for the freshman.
Yeah, but that was Elijah Ray. Took it away from him.
Speaking of a two, there's one for number two in Mason Archie, and the lead now grows to 17.
How about Mason Archie on the floater? Doesn't use the window. I'm just going to get it on the floater for the two.
Fuller, got it.
Well, stops the bleeding a little bit. You know, it's a 15-point advantage. They have not had very many clean looks at the basket.
First IUPUI turnover of the half. That's a dozen for the game. Covington for three.
See, Coach Gardner mentioning to Dave Ron, you've got to close out Garrett Covington. The matchup is good. Davron Williams can guard him, but he's got to close him out from the three. We know he can shoot it.
Good look to Ray. Ray bobbles. Has the presence of mind to tip it to a teammate.
That was a great save.
Not that time for Barksdale. Little run here by Western. They've scored the last five. Make it seven as Covington gets the bucket, and he's now got a dozen. And now Jason Gardner will ask for a 30-second timeout. And as mentioned, but his son Matt, a walk-on at the University of Notre Dame in basketball, if you're playing at Cathedral.
Right.
And then a buddy of both yours and mine, Mike Bohan, sitting right behind him.
Longtime official here in the state in high school and college.
Roberts Burnett in there for Western Illinois. Barksdale fires that one across to Boutte, then proceeds to get it right back and to the basket. Not that time. IUPUI looking for some contact there. No whistle. These guys have been given some freedom to play physically in tonight's game.
I think that's being generous, Greg. It's been very physical. It's also been very consistently called.
No doubt. And it's been that way from the opening tip. And as we talk about that, there's a hand check foul. That one's whistled on DJ McCall. That'll be his third. And that leads us to the media timeout. Players tonight in uniform, eight have played. IUPUI, 10 have seen action so far, which has been their norm most of this season. 10, if not 11, have seen game time. Ankrum drives, misses. He's looking for contact that never came. Boutte to Brennan, tried to leave it for James and throws it away. Turnover 13 for IUPUI. And Covington now with 14, and it's suddenly an eight-point game.
Starting to find his rhythm, which you expected him to do. He's especially dangerous in transition.
Western Illinois has made their last, or four of their last five field goal tries here in this half.
They've crept back in it, Greg.
Svetty to the basket. That's not normally his game. Good to see Leo get his first bucket.
Now his M.O. is a standing shooter from three, but again, we've talked about it before. If you're a standing shooter, make him honor the dribble and make him give you some space.
Svetty began his career at Western Michigan. Missed last year due to a knee injury. Really had missed the last 2 years due to knee injuries in high school and college. Roberts Burnett does not get it to go, and James will snare the rebound. Quick look for James. James with a mismatch goes to work. Up and under. That's a move that kid didn't have a year ago.
No, he didn't. But, again, we talked about it at the beginning of the half. What do? Differently, you got to go quickly in the post. You can't bounce it. You got to make a move or kick it out. Josh James made a quick step through to the rim.
It's also a great recognition by the guard. He needed a mismatch to get him the ball.
Absolutely.
And James did a great job that time of being 6'9". He's kept his arms straight up. Barksdale, not that time. And Marcellus, not a natural three-point shooter, but certainly has had it going this evening. That's his first miss from distance. He also just picked up the foul, though, and that is his third. And that'll also take us back to our next media timeout. A little bit of a decision to make here for Jason Gardner. Your best player had...
You buy him some time. You know, get a couple of minutes right now when you've got a double-digit lead. Buy him some time and things start to change, like things like that. Again, you might get him back in. His rest may be short-lived.
Archie blinked for a moment, and Covington shot right over him.
He's too good to have an entire game like he did the first half. He had five at the half.
Covington, 31 last week against South Dakota, as Archie answers the two at the other end. But to finish the thought, that was the most points a Western player had in a game in 8 years.
Right.
Dating back to November of 2006.
I like this move. Coach Gardner going to go a little zone. Hasn't done it yet, hasn't pressed this ball game. So now you got the matchup at the half court, and you better make sure you find that guy.
He missed, a rarity, but Conde there for a putback. And finally going to be fouled by James on a reach-in, just the fourth IUPUI team foul of the half.
Well, I think everyone understands the risk you run in the zone is rebound responsibilities, but you got to find Garrett Cunningham, get a hand in his face, and if you can step out and make him step out just a little further.
Covington now with 17 of the Western 39.
I thought he was going to pull the trigger.
Nice slip. Draws three defenders, and that'll be over to back violation.
That's great defense. You mentioned it. You know, the shot fake, the pass, the cut. And the instant he caught it in the lane, when Covington caught it, there were three white shirts.
And really in that situation, Bob, the baseline was the fourth defender.
It was the fourth defender, and I think it would have been better served to just go ahead and take it to the rim. Take your chances. But bottom line, that's pretty good defense. If they went back man on the inbound, went zone for one possession.
James going to work down low and scores.
That's impressive now for the young guy. You know, the catch, the one bounce, the turn, the finish in traffic.
We said this in November. I think it still holds true in February. Most improved player from a year ago.
No argument here. I think it's a pretty easy decision. He's just made progress in leaps and bounds, so to speak. Now they go back zone at the half court, Greg.
Good double down low. That leads to a shot off the side of the backboard from Chapman.
For the Knights, they've limited Western Illinois under 30% from the field, just like that.
They've kind of answered this first run by Western.
That's important.
Archie tries to bull his way in, and Brennan does the same on the weak side glass and scores.
Bad ankle and all, but you talked about the importance of Aaron Brennan, an energy player who will just fight through things, give you, he can knock down jump shots, he can rebound, he can defend.
The largest lead was 17. It's back to 15 for IUPUI. Chapman left hand, no, but I'd say Archie got just enough of a hand on him while he was shooting to draw the whistle.
I'd say this, he did foul him in position, put two hands on his back and kind of shoved him. I'm not so sure he fouled him on the shot, but he did get fouled.
Chapman from the Bronx, 6'8", tallest player on the active roster for Western Illinois. As is frequently the case, they have recruited heavily from the community colleges in Illinois and throughout the... I was going to say, that's two shots, guys.
Yeah.
That's, yep.
A little different to come from the Bronx and go to Macomb, Illinois.
Having only been briefly to the Bronx and have been way too many times to count to Macomb, I can see where you're coming from on that point.
Tell you what, I like him. I like what he does.
He's strong. A 53% shooter from the line.
Yeah, but you know what? He's a strong player. He's an energy guy at both ends. The 53% hurts you at the free throw line, no question.
Chance for the Jaguars to tie or even go bigger on a three than their largest lead of this game. And to do so with less than 9 minutes to play. Chapman shows you some toughness right there.
I tell you, that's why I like him.
James.
How about him?
That ball ended up being deflected into the basket for James. Sometimes it's just your night. That ball pinballed about five different directions in the final 5 seconds of the shot clock.
Here's where he's improved, Greg. In other games, there was too much thought. It was catch, think. Now it's catch, react, and get to the rim, and there's a big difference.
Had a tough matchup, though. They got squared up against Covington, and Covington buries an 18-footer.
In fairness, that's a tough matchup for anybody.
Covington now with 19. And he's got 14 of Western's 16 here in the half.
Well, and really, you know, they've had other opportunities that just haven't gone.
Svetty to the bucket again, and that's an offensive foul. Chapman was there waiting on him.
Chapman doing the dirty work. Think about it. So you see him step in here, gets off. He's clearly there.
And he caught an inadvertent elbow from Svetty in the process.
Leo Svetty becoming more of a penetrator in this ballgame, Greg. We know him as a spotted shooter.
The good news for IUPUI is that Barksdale sat with three fouls in the last 4 minutes, and the lead has actually increased for IUPUI.
Yeah, and the good thing is, you know, you still have time. Let him get a little more rest and let him finish out the ballgame.
Archie now back on Covington. And that's going to be a blocking foul on Archie. And Jason Gardner saying, hey, that's all elbow contact. Covington to shoot one plus the bonus. He is 2 of 4 tonight. Of note, Barksdale remains on the bench with three fouls for IUPUI.
Well, I think Coach Gardner feels like this group's got some rhythm, doing well defensively, as you pointed out. It bumped up the lead. You know, ride the hot hand, so to speak. Go with the guys that are playing. Marcellus, it's an impressive stat line, 22 points, 5 rebounds, and 19 minutes of play.
Covington with 20. Certainly, he's going to be on an all-conference team or two. And those get announced midweek next week for the Sioux, where the tournament starts in Sioux Falls next Saturday.
Well, they start, you know, Western Illinois trying to pick up the pace a little bit in the backcourt. I'm with you. If Covington is not one of the honored teams, we need an investigation.
Three for Svetty. That's a big shot. First made three of the half for IUPUI.
Yeah, he's the only one besides Marcellus Barksdale to knock down a three. You like it. You know, the two penetrating drives, the three times he's touched it, he's taken it to the rim. This one, the catch, the shoot.
Conde, no. James, the rebound.
Just great defense by James. Forcing that kind of shot, making him shoot a little bit quicker.
6 points, three rebounds.
And yes. Oh! Lamont, help us out. Come on now.
Muhammad Conde with the foul.
Hey, this is a great. Now, again, quick catch and move. You're up one level of play. They're counting that.
You don't see two officials that get more work than Terry Weimer and Lamont Simpson, who are the two guys
wonderful.
You see on screen right now. Daryl Smith, our third official this evening.
This crew's done a great job, Greg. They really have.
No need to be in a hurry here if you're IUPUI.
No, but here's the thing you have to guard against this amount of time is that you kind of let up a little bit. You know, you get deep and you don't think you have to hurry offensively. You take some time. You find yourself deep in shot clock, not taking great shots. But that's only the fourth turnover of the half. I say that only the fourth. That's an improvement from the first half.
Chapman, no. Fight for the loose ball. Brennan able to save it, and that's going to be a foul on Chapman going for the loose ball. I've got that as his fourth, but just the team's fourth of the half.
You know, Chapman has everything except the basket. You know, he's got the good move, the shot fake, the step through. Couldn't get it off the glass. Hustles and gets the foul.
The posts for IUPUI have done a good job of not trying to do too much defensively.
That's a great point.
They've just walled up and played their position.
You know, that is a great point. You know, the other thing, too, is that they've been right there. They've done a nice job of denial. They've also done a nice job of stepping out on screens. But you're right, inside, they've done a great job of not fouling.
Archie for three. Chapman with the rebound.
Had the look you wanted from the guy you wanted.
Good look. And Chapman the finish. A rare basket this half for a player other than Garret Covington.
Great pass by J.C. Fuller. And I think obviously when Chapman's able to go to the right hand, he's much more effective, much more efficient.
And here comes a wave of substitutions for IUPUI. This group has been on the floor now for a while. And that's going to be an offensive foul against P.J. Boutte.
Yeah, the question, you'll see it here, does he have enough space? That's the question mark.
Well,
initially, I thought the official was going to go with the block because there wasn't enough. It's time and distance, and there wasn't enough.
What we can't see that the official did from that angle was there a little bit of a lead with an arm that created that contact?
But I'm telling you, in terms of time and distance, this is one of the prerequisites. There wasn't enough time nor distance.
All right, points needed this trip for Western Illinois. Good look, Condi to finish. He's got six, and it's back to a 12-point game.
See what I say? I mean, again, you don't want to relax when you get to this particular stage, and it's certainly easier to say than it is to do. We want to continue to go to the rim and do the things that got you this lead.
Fresh legs on the floor for IUPUI. Four new faces on the floor. Ray, McCall, Barksdale, and Williams had been seated for a while. Shot clock at 11. Boutte is going to put that on the rim to keep the possession alive. Didn't get the shot to go. And Conde bobbles but recovers. Covington off the handoff. Not that time. And they're going to get Elijah Ray for a push in the back. One plus the bonus coming up for Western Illinois.
Yeah, Garret Covington never got himself steadied. Just never got himself ready. But again, stop clock, chance to score with a stopped clock, Greg. And if they make two, and we know that Chapman has some difficult, that's Condi at the line. You know, not a great free throw shooter himself.
55%. He's already made two tonight. But got that one to go. Condi averages 6 points and six rebounds a game, and he's got 7-4 at this juncture.
And don't look now. It's 11. Could be 10.
Well, that's kind of the way this half has gone.
Yeah, absolutely.
The lead has varied between 8 and 17 in this half. Just 4.5 minutes, though, left to play.
But you sense, though, Western Illinois has really ramped up what they're doing defensively, doing a great job of hedging the screen and rotating back. They've done a much better job of taking away dribble penetration.
Again, shot clock at 11. Boutte fouled, which means a fresh 35 for IUPUI because that is just the 15th foul against the Leathernecks.
Again, you just on-ball defense by Western, pretty good. P.J. Boutte, quick move to the baseline, but you think about it. There haven't been the lanes, the opportunities to go to the rim off the dribble in this half.
Barksdale with 22, but it's been a while since he added to that total. And Ray called for steps, turnover 17 against IUPUI.
Now 405, 10-point lead. You got to be careful. You got a guy like Garret Covington who can knock down jump shots, knock down threes. Covington is a guy who's crucial in this particular stage.
McCall, the freshman, gets the defensive assignment. And did a great job. And Boutte did an even better job of keeping Conde some 8 inches taller away from that loose ball.
Well, you know, forced shot by their best player. But that, as you mentioned, Greg, great defense at the half court.
A lot of times you'd say freshman on the best defensive assignment, so to speak, not good. Not the case, though, with McCall.
Not at all, because he's a great defender. He can guard three or four different positions.
Good luck, but not the finish for Williams. Good scramble by Boutte.
He wanted
to get a timeout, but the jump ball there good enough is deemed necessary.
Good job of officiating. You got to him real quickly. Everybody steps in. Play on.
Get a full 35 for IUPUI to work with. Brennan back in there now replacing Elijah Ray.
You can go deep into possessions now. I mean, you really can. Sometimes you get into it a little early. I think you can do it right now.
Shot clock at 13. And Williams fouled, and again, because that's team foul number 6, this requires Western to play another 30 seconds of defense.
Yeah, but it's 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Billy Wright going, you're that deep. The problem is he fouls out. Oh, my goodness.
Jalen Chapman picks up his 5th. It is a Western Illinois team.
See, I thought it was Condi who got him, they were both there doubling up. That's a loss. That's a big loss. Energy kind of player. Can do a lot of things. You bring in your shooter now.
By my tally, Western's had 9 fouls tonight, 5 of them on Chapman.
Absolutely. But again, it allows IUPUI to get another possession. You're running out of time.
Barksdale shot blocked by Fuller and rebound by Sandifer. Ball somehow finds Covington. He lets McCall fly by and hits a 2. Foot on the line, a 2-point shot. So it's now an 8-point game. This is as close as Western has been this half.
Because Western's gone a little smaller. Obviously, they went with Ankrum on the 5th foul of Chapman. So you went smaller. And the problem is, if you're Ankrum, you got to guard Davron Williams inside. So that's an advantage for the Jaguars.
8 consecutive points for Western Illinois. The last IUPUI bucket came some 5 minutes ago. McCall, no. Williams, yes, and forget about that stat.
Well, that's made possible again because Ankrum is matched up with him, and you'll see the replay. Ankrum does not get a body on him, and you've got to get on Davron Williams. And again, it's Garret Covington. You got to find him. You cannot get him in, let him have any space.
And Jason Gardner asks for time. 6 from the free throw line this evening. Boutte, the one-man press break. And he has a wall of purple chasing him. Bad pass by Boutte. Chance to make it a 2-possession game. And Covington stumbles. Now Archie races to the other end. And Archie grabbed. It does not matter. And 1 for Mason Archie.
Well, it's a spectacular play. I mean, it's just great defense to go back to force the turnover by Covington. And Mason Archie, the contact, the finish, big basket. I think you can breathe a little easier now if you're Jason Gardner.
Mason Archie with 6 tonight. Young man that attended Davidson College before making his way back to his hometown of Indianapolis. And now is 7, right at his average on the year.
Again, you can't let up. It's a minute and a half, so to speak, minute 20. Find Covington. Hand in his face. Do not let him catch and shoot.
Fuller got it.
Or you might want to find Fuller. J.C. Fuller, we know, can pull up and knock down jump shots.
You almost felt that any player not named Covington shooting that ball was a win.
Yeah.
And Covington gives the foul on Barksdale, and Barksdale will shoot one plus the bonus on the seventh team foul committed by Western Illinois.
If you're Western Illinois, probably not a bad foul. Marcellus, we know, a sub-70% free throw shooter. This is just a pretty simple little screen. D.J. McCall kind of hesitating to get over it, allow some space. You know, a situation like that, that late in the ball game, you've got to tighten up. You've got to be closer, hand in the face.
And important to note, one plus the bonus, not the two-shot variety yet. And Marcellus makes that fact inconsequential with a free throw that gives him a new career high of 23 points.
It's all him tonight. This has been a great night for Marcellus Barksdale. That's a heck of a way to celebrate your 100th game as a Jaguar.
Third consecutive game of 15 or more points for Marcellus. Makes them both. 9-point game, just over 60 seconds to play. McCall flies at Covington but didn't get there in time, and Western Illinois will take their final timeout. Great play designed by Western Illinois and poor recognition by IUPUI.
Staggered screen, and then Covington just after the first pass.
Barksdale can run the baseline here and finds McCall. Still plenty of time for IUPUI. And Archie again, Boutte a wild pass, but McCall able to track it down, and now Barksdale is fouled.
They went for two traps, which is good. I mean, got the first one in the corner, got the second one here at midcourt. Didn't have, almost got the thing they wanted, but, you know, that deep they had to take the foul.
Ninth team foul, so one plus the bonus here. And this one can make it a three-possession game with Western being out of timeouts. And a miss. And the guy that, well, Covington had the ball in his hands, but Fuller gets another good look, and that one rattles in. Now, next foul puts IUPUI in the double bonus. Dangerous pass.
Close. You know, the strategy is get one trap, foul if it gets out. So you're going to play the foul game. But that pass, yikes.
So two shots for Archie with 31 seconds left to play.
You know, if you're Western Illinois, you have time. Mason Archie can do a big thing for his teammates with two. Big free throw.
Needed to get at least one.
Yeah, big free throw.
Two would be nice, but needed to get one.
If you're IUPUI, don't foul. Especially don't foul a jump shooter. And if you're Western Illinois, I think I'm a big advocate of going to the rim since you're down five. You still need two possessions, but I think they'll take the three if they have it.
Fuller fouled by McCall.
The one thing you didn't want to do is foul a shooter, turn the clock off on you. Let him score without any time off the clock. If he makes these two, you got the same scenario. You go for the first trap. If you don't get out, you pick somebody to foul, closest man you have.
Fuller, a 74% free throw shooter. It's his first look at the line tonight. Young man from Sioux City, Iowa.
Free throw shooter, looks like it too.
He's now got 13. He averages 11 a game. Just six players have scored tonight. Only eight have played for Western Illinois. And got that one too. Back to a one possession game.
You got to be careful. Obviously, you got to get the ball in, Greg. Number one, you can't have a 5-second violation. You cannot turn it over.
And a timeout given to IUPUI. Now there was a timeout given before the jump ball.
Yeah, he has timeout. They have it. Good call. It's a good call. But that was a great trap. And that is a great timeout by Jason Garden, because I think he senses that is a trap, that they're in deep trouble trying to get it out of there.
Darrell Smith was the official that called for the jump ball, but at least a 6 of 27 meetings over an 11-year span of conference play. Jaguars went from January of 2000 until December of 2008 without losing to this team from Macomb, Illinois. And Boutte will shoot two free throws, his first two of the game.
Well, you get it to your best ball handler. You know, you're going to get to, he knows he's going to get fouled. It takes away the trap opportunity, which Western Illinois wasn't able to apply. Yeah, now, I mean, here you're going to put Covington at the lane. I thought Billy Wright was going to bring him down, spot him up, and throw ahead and have him knocked down, but is there anybody in the building that doesn't know he needs to make these?
Got that one to go. P.J. with five tonight. He averages 5.5 a game. He's an 81% free throw shooter.
Well, again, same scenario. You know, look for Fuller to try to penetrate to the rim and try to get the quick two.
Missed by Boutte, rebound by Covington.
Covington all the way.
And Covington will take it all the way, and he's fouled by Williams. 15 seconds left to go.
See, the problem there, Greg, is the one thing you don't want to do is foul a shooter. You don't want to give up three, okay? You don't want to give up the three from the three-point arc, or you don't want to give up a and-one situation.
Covington missed his first two free throws. He has since made his last four. But doesn't make that one. And makes this one. It's a one-possession game. And Western will go back to the foul game that they have done quite well these last minutes to keep in this game. IUPUI led 59-43 as Covington makes that one, and he's got 30.
Again, you know, Western Illinois will go for the trap. First trap, don't have it, you foul.
So Fuller commits the foul, and now Boutte will again shoot two. Just 1.6 seconds come off the clock from the free throw. This is one of those games that cannot end fast enough for IUPUI.
Well, one way to do it, don't foul. Get the clock moving.
PJ makes this one.
Well, we know the strategy. It's pretty clear. Western Illinois is going to try to go to the rim as fast as they can. They have no other options, you know, right now. That or, the, you know, penetrate, find a spotted shooter.
Boutte again makes just one of two, leaves the door open. Covington takes some time, misses that one. Barksdale, the rebound. Western gives the foul, and that should just about do it. Again, love the effort from Western Illinois. It's a team that has won just once since January the 4th. It was against this IUPUI team.
Right.
But not many teams have the wherewithal to come back from 17 down in the second half.
They played hard. They played well. Just great defense by P.J. Boutte. Just right on Covington, never let him get a look. And it's an impressive win, Greg. You could say the same things about the Jaguars. They'd not been playing well, and a very spirited and confident group came in tonight and played well, defended well, Greg, all night long. Really, really did a nice job on the defensive end of the floor tonight.
One thing that IUPUI did not do well tonight is shoot free throws. As Barksdale hits that one, they're going to finish right at about 50% for the night, but they will finish with a home victory, their fifth of the season. Fuller's last shot does not go. And